This is what's left of a minivan following an accident in Lancaster County. A family of four was riding in it when a runaway horse plowed into it. Tonight, we have an update on the family's condition. It's tonight's top story. Good evening. I'm Ron Martin.
I'm Janelle Stelson. Today was the first day back at school for one of the daughters after being hurt in Sunday night's crash. The mother, she's still in the hospital. News 8's Lancaster County reporter Caitlin Smith spoke with her family.
This picture says it all.
It was gut-wrenching.
On the left, a horse, head first, half inside the Matterns van.
What was it like when you saw the car?
Knowing that my sister was sitting in the passenger seat, knowing how the seat was, and knowing that she took the full impact, it was made you cry.
37-year-old Amanda Mattern and her family were almost home from the beach. The force slammed her seat back. The horse wrapped its hooves around her 9-year-old daughter, Kylie, who was asleep in the seat behind her. It happened on Route 30, right by Black Horse Road. First responders say it's the worst crash they've seen. The horse died. Amanda is the only one still in the hospital with a brain injury.
Just an hour ago, she opened up her eyes for the first time. It was good.
Her husband, Brian, was driving. He's not ready to talk on camera, but says he remembers his 6-year-old daughter behind him was calm. His other daughter was screaming. Police say an Amish family was trying to harness the horse when it got loose.
There's really nothing to see here now, but there are two images Brian says he can't stop seeing. One is that huge horse he says was running full speed right at him, and the other is the image of his wife right after the impact.
That was really hard listening to that from him, because we knew how upset he was.
But Amanda is getting better each day.
And that's all we can ask for.
In Lancaster County, Caitlin Smith, News 8.
The family has set up websites to update Amanda's condition and to raise money for her medical bills and other expenses. We have that information at WGAL.com.